Good morning, everyone. Did you have a good old neighbor? Nikki Confusion 2 and No Time to Die Fan 2001, yo. And welcome to another amazing video. And now I am finally going to do a review of Rogue One, the Star Wars story. Boy, Star Wars Rogue One, because call it a Star Wars story. This has to be one of the worst things that Lucasfilm ever did, next to Leia and Kylo Ren kissing, which honestly, I cannot stand that kissing, and I definitely agree with Frozen, and Wimbush right back about that. Anyway, guys, before I get started, the reason why I'm doing this review of Star Wars Rogue One is because of the new, probably it's because of the new Star Wars show is called Captain Otto, which honestly, I'm so looking forward to that show, so that's why I'm doing the review of this movie, because this movie is coming on IMAX this year. Back again, so if you haven't seen the movie on IMAX, I recommend you go to your local, go to your local IMAX theater in your local area, and you can have a fun time for this. So I was really disappointed that I did not see this movie in theaters back in 2016, because I was planning to go and see it, but I was way back then that Marcus went to see this movie without me, so I was really disappointed about that. Anyway, guys, my very first Star Wars movie I saw in theaters, it had to be Star Wars The Last Jedi. Honestly, I used to hate that movie, but now I think this movie is a really underrated gem. Anyway, guys, so today I'm doing a movie review of Star Wars Rogue One. I'm not calling it a Star Wars story because that's stupid. How it came out of year of 2016. I don't understand why some people think 2016 is easily one of the worst years ever. Have you not seen 2020? Like, come on, we got COVID, we got movies delay, we got people passed away, we got cuties, and we got so many crappy movie in 2020. And yes, I know there's some good movie like Tenet, Wonder Woman 1984, The Cruise 2, which honestly, I used to like that movie, but now I just... starting my thought on The Cruise 2 is starting to get really downhill. But I might explain about that on my Instagram. And so, hey guys, and maybe I could think about calling The Cruise 2 a underwhelming DreamWorks movie. So, I wish that sequel could be better anyway. Anyway, guys, I don't want to tell a story because I don't want to give away a bunch of spoil for this movie. I don't care if this movie came out 2016. The bottom line is, I don't want to spoil for good movies. The only thing I spoil for good movies is Frozen 2 and the MCU movies. That's it. I'm not spoiling any good movies. Oh, don't forget No Time to Die. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. So, let's talk about my thought on this movie. So after this movie came out, a lot of people was underwhelmed for this movie, and a lot of people was really like this movie. But here's our one YouTuber really did not like this movie. His had to be the stupid fan 2001, aka the NSF fan 2001, which honestly, I don't understand why he hates this movie, because this is an original Star Wars movie right here. This is honestly one of the most original Disney Star Wars movie I ever seen in my life. So anyway, guys, we're doing to Revenge of the Sith is easily one of the best Star Wars movie I have ever seen in the planet. But after I watched this movie last year, and I gotta say, but I definitely agree with Frozen 2 fanboy 2004, or you could call it Frozen the movie credit. And you know what? Let's call him Frozen 2 fanboy 2004, because I know Frozen got a new girlfriend, which honestly I don't want to explain about that because I don't want people to be triggers. So yeah. And so, hey guys, and I gotta say, but Rogue One, the Star Wars story, this is easily one of the best Star Wars movie by Disney. And this is easily one of the best Disney Star Wars movie I have ever seen in my life. But is this my favorite Star Wars movie ever? Nah, I think Revenge of the Sith is easily one of the best Star Wars movie I ever seen. Anyway, guys, I still have some few negative about the movie. First off, we have to talk about the score of the film. The score of the film is not bad, but it's forgettable because honestly, every single time I watched this movie and I just heard a different score, and I was like, what movie is this? What movie is it? Because it didn't, John Williams, what happened to you, man? What happened to you? Because your score, it did not sound like anything like Star Wars. It kind of sounded like you're watching the different action movie feature Star Wars, in my opinion. Anyway, guys, the only negative I have for this movie is the score. And the one character named Saul, no, not Saul movie, I'm talking about Saul, the characters. He got killed off with John Z. I don't understand why they killed off that character with John Z. He was very important character, but ain't wrong, they killed it, and honestly, I did not like that. So that's the only negative I have for this movie. The rest of the movie is completely awesomeness. So you guys, Let's talk about my pause about the movie. We had to get the story. The story is honestly one of the this is honestly one of the most original Star Wars I ever seen, because I definitely agree with Robert Storm enjoyed this movie, because I really love this movie. This movie is a really original Star Wars movie, and this is easily one of the different Star Wars movie I ever seen, because this movie is a really original Star Wars movie right there. Hey guys, if you want to see an original Star Wars movie, then The Rise of PoopWalker, how about this movie? Because this movie is easily one of the best Disney Star Wars movie ever. The worst Disney Star Wars movie I've ever seen is Rise of PoopWalker, aka Rise of Skywalker. I might do a rant of that movie, because I still hate that movie, but honestly, I think Terminator Dark Fate is easily one of the worst movie of 2019, so I don't want to go full rip-off claim. And sorry guys, and the character, which honestly, I really love the main character of this movie. The female main character, mwah, chef kiss. I love that character. She's pretty cute, and she's also pretty hot too, for the Star Wars character. And we got a character, so honestly, maybe looking at my Wikipedia, my Instagram, so I made a tune style of Rogue One, so sorry guys. We got Otto, which honestly, his show is coming out of this year, which honestly, I'm so looking forward to it. And K2CO, I love that character. That character is easily one of the best, this is easily one of my second favorite Star Wars characters in this movie, because he is really a likable character. And the villain of this movie, which honestly, I really enjoy the villain of this movie. The villain of this movie is a really well done villain. He's just like a Star Wars version of the villain from Ready Player One. The main reason why I'm saying that is because they're both performed by same actor. He was in Spy in Disguise as a villain. He's in Ready Player One as a villain, and now he's in Rogue One as a villain. So let's see, he could be as a villain in the YouTube movie. Will be like the Lord of the Rings in the YouTube verse. Yeah, my YouTube verse is not happening right now because the water YouTuber is busy in life, so I'm just going to make YouTube movie like The Lord of the Ring and The Hobbit. Sorry, guys. And Saul, honestly, I don't understand why they kill off Saul, which honestly, I don't understand it. So that's only negative. The same thing with the score. Honestly, let's get the character. Honestly, I do like the character Saul. He's a really likable character of the movie. So yeah. And Rock, no, not the Rock. I'm talking about the Rock. Honestly, he's not in the poster. Honestly, the character named Walk, he's a really likable character. I just do remember his last name. I just don't remember his first name. Sorry, guys. And we got Darth Vader. Oh, boy. Darth Vader. Comeback of the great comeback from James Earl Jones. Honestly, if you know him, he was in the Star Wars movie. He was as Mufasa from The Lion King. But honestly, one of the best performances I ever seen for James Earl Jones is had to be him as Darth Vader. I know a lot of people say Mufasa is easily one of his best performances ever, but honestly, I do like Mufasa. I do understand that. But the bottom line is, I just think Darth Vader is easily one of his best performances he ever did. And he did a really good job in this movie, because, yeah, in the ending of the film, I don't want to explain about the ending, so yeah. And we got the Star Trooper, which honestly, the Star Trooper is just like the same thing in the Star Wars, which honestly, the Star Trooper, they're doing pretty good in this movie. And Mode, honestly, the one girl telling that one main character about what happened to the Star Wars, the Death Stars, which honestly, she is a really likable character. I really like her, but I do like the main character of the film more than her. And the action of the film. For the Disney Star Wars, but this is easily one of the best action scene I have ever seen by Disney Star Wars. This is easily one of the best action scene I ever seen by Disney. OMG, every single action scene of this movie is really entertaining. It makes you shove your popcorn in your mouth, which honestly, kids, don't do that. honestly, don't do that, kid. Don't do that because you're going to get choked. I'm probably going to say, mommy, mommy. Okay, that was really stupid. And sorry, guys, and the climax of the film. I really enjoy the climax of the film. The climax of the film, I don't want to explain about the climax because it's a huge manga spoiler. And sorry, guys, and the ending of the film is really a sweet ending. And this is how the movie ends, so I don't want to explain about the ending because I don't want to give away a bunch of spoilers once again. So, hello guys, welcome to Star Wars Story, aka Star Wars Rogue One. This is easily one of the best Disney Star Wars movie I have ever seen. Where even the score was really forgettable, where even the one character named Saul got killed off, which honestly, I did not like that. But the story, the character, the action scene, the climax, the visual effects and special effects, all the great Star Wars thing is still alive. Well, even the Star Wars president not doing a great job for Lucasfilm, but she did a really good job to tell the director to make this movie. But I think this movie is way better than Solo the Star Wars Story. Honestly, I used to like the movie, but now I think the movie was pretty mediocre. So, yeah. And so, honestly, I won't mind that Solo the Star Wars Story bombed the box office, because I hate to say it, but it deserved it, because that was really unnecessary that I have a production in it. And so was Star Wars Story. This is easily one of the most nightmare reshot movies I ever seen, next to Joss's Reed. And sorry guys, and I don't understand why some people think this movie is overrated. No. This movie is not overrated. This movie is underrated in my opinion. And this movie is easily one of the best Disney Star Wars movie I ever seen. And this movie is way better than Phantom Menace, Attacking the Clone. Even Attack of the Clone is not as bad as people think it is, but it's still bad. And this is way better than Rise of PoopWalker. Every single time I think about Rise of PoopWalker, yeah, that movie sucked major donkey ball. And sorry guys, I think Phantom Menace is easily one of the worst Star Wars movies I ever seen. But I think Revenge of the Sith is easily one of the best Star Wars movies I ever seen. And I think Obi-Wan Kenobi, this is easily one of the best Star Wars shows I ever seen, which is Obi-Wan Kenobi and Machonzi. I think Obi-Wan Kenobi, this is easily one of the most underrated shows of 2022. So let's see how She-Hulk's gonna pull off in that MCU anyway. Anyway guys, I am giving Rogue One audience. Sorry about that. I am giving the Star Wars Rogue One a 9 out of 10. I love it, and this movie definitely deserves a seal of nitpick awesomeness. And the reason why I'm doing this review is because, one, there's a new auto Star Wars show is coming on in Disney Plus this fall. And number two, Rogue One is coming back in IMAX. Whoop whoop! So on August 26th, get your Star Wars stuff, go to the IMAX, and you can have fun and experience. And not just this movie. No. You get an exclusive look on a new Star Wars show called Andor. Yeah, Andor. Like that show. I cannot wait. Cannot wait to watch that show. That show is going to be great. But it's not going to be... Honestly, it's not going to be as better than Obi-Wan Kenobi. I think Obi-Wan Kenobi will always be my favorite Star Wars show that I ever seen. And screw the haters who hate that show, by the way. So, yeah, that was my movie review of Star Wars Rogue One. I'm not going to call it a Star Wars story, because this has to be one of the worst Star Wars titles I've ever seen, next to Rise of PoopWalker. Rise of Skywalker. Because honestly, that movie is not Rise of Skywalker. How about you call it a Star Wars or Rise of PoopWalker, or Rise of CrapWalker, or even better, A Rise of the Toilet Walker. Ha 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 ha, very funny. And I'm probably showing you that's not going to laugh at it, because he's really a serious YouTuber. So I might do my part with Sean PBS video in the future. And sorry guys, I don't know if I want to go to the park today, because it's raining, it's going to be wet out, so I might stay in the house, and I might watch that new Predator movies. Sorry guys, if you like this movie, so really hope you like this movie, but if you hate this movie, I can accept your opinion. But for me, this is easily one of the most original Star Wars movie out there, next to Revenge of the Sith. And sorry guys, if you like this Rogue One video, please hit the subscribe button, join the kitchen, share with family, and stay tuned for a review of Otters, which is a Disney Plus Star Wars show coming out this fall. It's still summer, so fall is coming out pretty soon. Cannot wait. So yeah. And sorry guys, that's my end of my Star Wars review. Anyway, and I might do... I might do all the Star Wars review on December, so let me think about it. So, when I was way back then, I had to do my Christmas review week, so yeah. Sorry guys, you're getting two December. You're getting a Christmas review week, and you're getting a Star Wars review. Like, all the Star Wars movie leading up to the anniversary of Rise of PoopWalker. And sorry guys, if you like the Rise of PoopWalker, I can accept your opinion. But for me, this is easily one of the worst Star Wars movies I've ever seen. But Rogue One is way better than Solo Star Wars Story. And sorry guys, subscribe, comment, share with his family, and stay tuned for my video called My Problem with Sean PBS. Well, even I like Sean PBS, but here's some movies I disagree, like Batman v Superman with John C. Batman v Superman is not even worse than Ghostbusters 2016. You better cut that out, man. And sorry, guys. So, Sean PBS, hey, people. Hey, Sean PBS, if you're watching this, I know you hate BVS, but this is not even worse than Norman North of Independence Day Resurgent, and definitely not Ghostbusters 2016, because did you said Batman v Superman is even worse than Ghostbusters 2016? I'm sorry, Sean PBS, but you are out of your mind, because I think Ghostbusters 2016 is even worse than Batman v Superman. Yeah, don't hurt Zack Snyder's feeling, because that is not his fault. That's Warner Bros.' fault. Just don't blame him. So, I know you're not a huge fan of this filmmaker, but honestly, just give it a chance. Just give it a chance. Yeah, that's my huge problem about Sean PBS, because his opinion, his disagreement, honestly, there's the main reason why I'm doing my problem with Sean PBS after I get out of the shower. Sorry, guys. Subscribe, comment, show this family. This is E31, the longest Star Wars review I ever did. Sorry, guys. I see you next time. And someone can pinch your tooth. Have a great day, everyone. And I see you guys next time.